Hi, I'm Kim, and I love going to estate sales. It's a bit of a guilty secret, but I really do like doing that, and I get lots of interesting things. For example, notice the little cardigan that I'm wearing. This, I got this at an estate sale a little while ago, and I know it's fur, don't hate me, it's vintage, and it actually comes right off. Just clips right on, so I think someone probably add this as an after effect, but I love this sweater. The reason I like it is I think it's a great inspiration for an embroidery design, or a quilt motif actually, and I think it's very cute, and it's actually wool, so it's very nice. The other things I like to look for at estate sales are jewelry. I'm all about the bling, and if this isn't blinging enough for you, I don't know what is, but it's a great brooch. I think this would be perfect on a black dress for an event in the evening. And I also got this, and I had to look at this for a bit because it actually goes like this. It's a little scary, isn't it? If you know what this is, you knew more than I did when I bought it, although it looked vaguely familiar to you. This is a kilt pin. It's actually a grouse claw. I know, kind of eek, but kind of cool too, huh? So I think that's very neat. That's something else I picked up in one of my recent estate sales. But what I really love to go for is the linens, because who has those these days except older people? So when I go, I like to pick up some vintage linens if they have any. And so I get things like this. And I'm going to show you a whole bunch of what I got and what I'm going to do with them. This one in particular, I just like the design. It's not in the best shape color-wise, so I can try and get some of the stains out if I want. If not, I can hack it up and make it into a pillow or put it together for a quilt, something like that. I also like the design on it. I think that's inspirational too for perhaps an applique quilt pattern. So that's one of them. Then you run into other ones like this, which are like a tone-on-tone. And I don't know if you can see this detail on the bottom here, but this would make a great whole cloth quilt, or again, it's a bit stained, so if it doesn't come out, it could join the other one and go together and make something. Then we get into hankies, little hankies like this. This has a beautiful little motif on it. Also inspirational for embroidery designs for me. Here's another one, same sort of thing. Whoops, you gotta make sure it's the right way around, don't we? There we go. Another one again. So you blow this up, this would be a great applique piece as well. Make it a lot bigger, be a perfect little wall hang. Something else, very pretty, a little dresser runner. Again, this would make a great whole cloth quilt. Or you have big, this is only a quarter of it. So this is stitched on all sides. This is very pretty. You might just use this as a table topper in the house because it's really very pretty. Or again, a great applique piece. And then you get into these crochet things, okay? So you get these little guys that are like little coasters, I guess, really. But I like to get these. Or I like to get pieces like this. Again, notice the circular motif in them. And you can actually cut these. You can cut them through and they won't unravel on you. So that's what I like to do, is I like to cut them into pieces because I use them in various pieces, such as this little stuffy myrtle here. Has some of these in the front and on the back. And I think they're very effective. They're also great to group together with some vintage buttons to make pillows. That's also cool. And if you don't like the color that they are, if they're maybe too white for you and you're not really keen on that look, you can always tea dye them or coffee dye them. In this case, I started tea dyeing. It wasn't quite dark enough. It didn't give me the vintage look I wanted. So I actually put some just instant coffee in it, let it soak, and you get darker colors. So these were actually white to begin with and they got a lot darker. And I like that look. I really do like that look. The other thing I tried was I got some lace and I thought, I don't think this is cotton, but it took the dye anyway. And then I can use it with my vintage linens. So that's why I like to go to estate sales.